Hello, and welcome to video 5.2, Evaluating Graph Polynomial Functions. First, we need to start off with a few definitions. So the first thing we're going to define is a monomial. And a monomial is a number, or a variable, or a product of numbers and variables. So that means like 2, or 2x, or x squared, because that's still a product, that's x times x. Alright, the next one we have is a polynomial. A polynomial, then, poly means many, and that is a monomial, or a sum of monomials. So, x would be considered a polynomial. X plus 5, 2x plus 7, x squared plus 3, x plus 2, any of these are polynomials. And we can go to higher powers now, so we will start talking about ones like x cubed, x to the 4th, things like that. And then standard form for polynomials, the terms are written in order from highest exponent to lowest. And we've already seen that a little bit with quadratics. We always start with the ax squared, that's the highest exponent, and then plus bx, that's the next highest exponent, and then plus c, that's no exponent. So a standard polynomial function is written in this format. F of x equals, and then n is going to be our highest power. So we have a sub n, which is just the coefficient that goes with the nth power, times x to the nth, n being whatever the highest power is. And then the next one would be the coefficient that goes with that next one, times x to the next lowest power. So if that n was a 4, then this one would be a 3. And so on, until we get to the coefficient with just x, and then the constant. So a few more vocabulary words for you. A sub n, that would be that first one, is the leading coefficient. So whenever you put your polynomial in standard form with the highest power first, the coefficient that goes with it, we call that the leading coefficient. So it's the one that comes first when it's in standard form. It must be a positive integer. All right, the n, this little n here, is the degree. So the highest power, the highest exponent of any one term in a polynomial. So if I give you a polynomial and it's got a whole bunch of different powers, the degree of it is the highest one. And then a sub 0, this one back here, that's the constant term. It doesn't have an x with it. It's the constant term. It won't change no matter what x is. All right, let's make a little table here. And we need three headings, degree, type, and example. And our degree, we're going to start with if we have a degree of 0. If I have no x's in my polynomial, all I have is y equals 5. We call that a constant. And so an example, I just said that. We'll go with f of x, though, to be more official, equals 5. Let's go one up now, the degree of 1. If our highest power is 1, so if I have y equals 2x, or 2x plus 3, or whatever, then that is linear. We learned about that at the beginning of the year. So an example would be f of x equals 2x plus 3. It doesn't have to have the plus 3. It could be 4x or 5x minus 2 or whatever, but the highest power is 1. All right, if we have a second power. We just did this chapter. These are quadratics. If x is squared, we have a quadratic. So an example would be f of x equals any quadratic you could think of, I don't know, 5x squared plus 8. Taking this a little further, if our degree was 3, if we had the highest power 3, that's a cubic. And a cubic might look like f of x equals 3x cubed. Or, and because I hadn't talked about this before, but this doesn't just have to be x. We could have y equals 2abc. It's got three variables in it, 1, 2, 3. We would still consider that to be cubic, even though they're all different variables. Okay, after 3 comes 4. And so if something was to the 4th power, we would call it quartic. For example, f of x equals, 2x to the 4th minus 7x plus 1. As long as the highest power is 4. And once again, it doesn't just have to be x. So we could have something like y equals 9wx squared y. Because that has 1, 2, 3, 4 variables in it. So that would still be considered quartic. And then anything after 4, we don't have a special name. We just call it 5th degree, 6th degree, 7th degree, and so on. All right, here are some examples. I want you to look at these, each of these, and tell me the degree, the type, and the leading coefficient. Degree, type, and leading coefficient. So if you want, you can hit pause and you can try them yourself, or you can just listen. All right, this first one, you look, degree is always your highest power. And in this case, our highest power is 4, so our degree is 4. Type, well, a fourth degree is quartic. And our leading coefficient is going to be the coefficient on the highest power, which in this case, there's not one there, so it is 1. Don't be a fool and put 0. It's 1. All right, the second one. F of x equals 5x squared plus 3x to the negative 1 power minus x. So x to the negative 1 power, that's the same thing as 1 over x. And if you look back to our definition, a monomial is a number variable or product of numbers and variables. This is not a product. This is a quotient. So because it's not in that definition, this is not a polynomial at all. And it's a function, and we'll learn about these later, but it's not a polynomial. All right, this third one then. We have 7x minus the square root of 3 plus pi x squared. And so some of you are looking at those weird symbols and thinking, okay, well then it's not a polynomial either because it's got all this weird stuff. But square root of 3 is just a simple number, and this is 7 times x, and pi is just a number. So this is a sum of monomials, which are numbers, variables, and products of numbers and variables. So our highest power is 2. That would be our degree. That would make it quadratic. And the leading coefficient, don't be fooled, it's not 7, just because the 7 is first. It's not what comes first, it's what goes on the highest power. Because if you were to put it in standard form, then that would go first. So our leading coefficient is pi. All right, and then the last one, g of x equals x plus 2 to the x power minus 6x to the 5th power. If you look here, we have an x power. And so once again, that does not fall under the definition of polynomials. So this is not a polynomial. All right, so I want to talk about direct substitution, which you all know how to do. If I gave you a polynomial, f of x equals, this one just happens to be quadratic, and I said find f of 3, then you should know that that means to plug a 3 in everywhere where there's an x, so here and here. So we would say f of 3 is 2 times 3 squared plus 3 times 3 plus 1. And you can do that math real quick and you will get a 28. So f of 3 equals 28. And it's really easy, but we just want to make sure you know what direct substitution is. That's where you plug it in. But now, I'm going to teach you about synthetic substitution, and that's probably pretty new to you. All right, so here's a polynomial. I wrote the coefficients in a different color just to make them stand out a little bit. F of x equals 8x to the 4th plus 12x cubed minus 5x plus 9, and I'm going to find f of negative 2. And if I said use direct substitution, that would mean you would plug a negative 2 in for x. Be careful with your even powers. The negative is going to go away and all that stuff. But synthetic substitution is a quick and dirty way to do it. It's really kind of neat, but you're going to just have to watch how I set this up. First thing you're going to do is we're going to write our x value, the negative 2 that we're trying to find. And then we're going to put this box thing, and it's basically two lines long. Okay? So our x value is negative 2. So in this box here, we're going to put all of our coefficients. So the first one is 8. The second one is 12. And then you have to make sure this is x to the 4th power, this is x to the 3rd power, we don't have an x to the second power. So that's 0x to the second. We have to put a 0 in because you have to have one for each power. So 4, 3, 2, the x power then would be negative 5. This negative goes with it. And then 9. All right, so you copy down each of your coefficients, including zeros for any missing ones. All right, now here's how you're going to do this. You're going to copy the first one down. We're just going to say 8. If we didn't add anything to 8, we'd get 8. But then we're going to multiply. And I wrote down here, I probably should have typed it so it'd be neater, but it says multiply 8 by the x value. So we're going to take this 8 and multiply it by this negative 2. Negative 2 times 8 is negative 16, and we're going to write it in the next line. We're going to write it right here, negative 16. Okay, so we did negative 2 times 8 is negative 16. Then we're going to add down. 12 plus negative 16. 12 plus negative 16, here I'm going to write add here, is negative 4. And then we're just going to repeat the process over and over again until we're done. So now we're going to multiply negative 2 times negative 4. And you don't have to draw these circles and lines. I'm just showing you what I'm doing. Negative 2 times negative 4 is 8. 0 plus 8 is 8. Negative 2 times 8 is negative 16. Negative 5 plus negative 16 is negative 21. Negative 2 times negative 21 is 42. And 9 plus 42 is 51. So when you do that, it's actually pretty quick once you get used to it. This 51 is the magic number. That's the answer. If I wanted to know what is the function evaluated at negative 2, the answer is 51. If I were to directly substitute a negative 2 in for x, that's what I would get. So this is kind of cool. You want to practice this a few times in your homework. There is a prettier visual of this in the textbook if you want to look at that, if you don't follow my arrows and circles and football diagrams here. But otherwise, that's that. All right, and sorry if you thought I was done. I do have one more topic to cover, and that's end behavior of polynomial functions. We want to talk about when we graph our polynomials, our x squareds, our x cubes, our x to the fourths, what do the ends do? And the first thing that before I start talking, why don't you push pause? I want you to copy down this chart a little bit. But the first thing we want to talk about is our leading coefficient. If our leading coefficient is positive, so remember when we had quadratics, we said if it's positive, it's a happy parabola. The leading coefficient really only controls the right end. If the leading coefficient, look down here, if the leading coefficient is positive, it rises on the right. So anytime you are starting with a positive coefficient and you're trying to graph it, you will be rising on the right and it will go up at the right end. Okay, if your leading coefficient then is negative, you're going to do the opposite. You're going to fall on the right end. See that? So if the leading coefficient is negative, it falls on the right. The left end is actually controlled by the degree. So if the degree is odd, that's these two, if the degree is odd, the left side does opposite of the right. So I always think odd, opposite. So if the right was going up, the left is going down. Or if the right was going down, the left is going up. And then if the degree is even, it's doing the same. If the degree is even, the left is the same as the right. So when the degree is even, so the squareds and the quadratics and whatever, if it's going up on the right, it's also going up on the left. If it's going down on the right, it's going down on the left. So you always know what the ends are going to do for your polynomials based on the degree and the leading coefficient. And now it depends, the way you write it needs to be written the way it is on this chart. You're going to write, and this is kind of new and kind of weird, but this is how you're going to write it. For our right end, we will say f of x with an arrow approaches, and then since we're talking about y, we go to positive infinity as x approaches positive infinity. So it's saying as x moves to the right, y is going up. F of x approaches positive infinity as x approaches positive infinity. You have to write it this way. If you're not watching the video, if you're just writing the notes, you're not going to know that I said you have to write it this way. On the left end, our y value f of x is approaching negative infinity. It's going down as x approaches negative infinity. There's a very faint negative in there, just didn't copy over. As x is going to the left to negative infinity, y is going down to negative infinity, and it has to be written like this. Look at this one over here. On the left, we have f of x is approaching positive infinity. That means y is going up as x is approaching negative infinity, as it's going left. As it's going left, it's going up. On the right, we know on the right, it's going down. F of x approaches negative infinity, y is going down as x approaches positive infinity, as x is moving to the right. And we can look at all of these f of x on this one, left and up. So f of x positive infinity as x approaches negative infinity. Right and up, f of x approaches positive infinity as x approaches positive infinity. Remember, this is positive and this is negative over here. And down here on the left, as x approaches negative infinity, f of x approaches negative infinity. It's going down. And negative infinity as x approaches positive infinity. Make sure for the 50,000th time that you are writing it just like this, as you see on this page. And we will end with some examples. I've given you three functions. I want you to tell me what the end behavior is without even looking at the graph. So the first one, f of x equals x to the fourth plus 3. First thing we do is look at the leading coefficient, and it's positive. LC is positive 1. When it's positive, that means it's going to go up on the right. And then we look at the power, the degree, and that's 4, and that's an even number. Degree is 4. That's even. Even means same, so it's going to go up on the left. But you cannot on your test write up right, up left. You have to write it properly. F of x approaches infinity as x approaches infinity, and f of x approaches infinity up as x approaches negative infinity. So up right and up left. It has to be written like this. All right, look at the next one. And you can graph that in your calculator to verify it if you want to. Look at the next one, f of x equals x cubed plus 2x. So our leading coefficient is, once again, 1. That means it's going to go up on the right. And our degree, highest power, is 3. That's an odd number, and odds are opposite, so it's going to go down on the left. So that means that f of x approaches infinity as x approaches infinity up on the right. F of x approaches negative infinity as x approaches negative infinity down on the left. And one more, f of x equals negative x to the fifth plus 2. So our leading coefficient for this one is negative 1. That means it's going to go down on the right. And then our degree is 5. It's odd. Odd is opposite, so it's going to go up on the left. And we would say f of x approaches down on the right, so negative infinity as x approaches infinity. And f of x approaches up on the left, so positive infinity as x approaches negative infinity. So down right, up left. All right, and that's all I have for you. You guys have a good evening. Bye.